It can be discouraging how quickly we can forget information. Within a few minutes, we can forget up to half of what we studied. However, we can counteract this tendency to forget by utilizing rehearsal and repetition. Herman Ebbinghaus addressed this in 1885 when he described the forgetting curve, which is the rate at which we forget information over time if it is not repeated. Ebbinghaus advocated for overlearning and revisiting material through repetition and practice. Think about this with real-life examples. The more times you hear song lyrics, the more likely you are to remember their message. Repetition strengthens your memorization of that information and improves the amount of information you'll remember. This is why we don't recommend cramming. Cramming before a test doesn't leave time between study sessions for memory consolidation, and it creates a level of stress that may compromise your attention and focus. An effective alternative to cramming is to space out your studying with a method known as distributed practice. Distributed practice allows our brains the time needed to consolidate information between study sessions. Feist and Rosenberg attribute this to the important role sleep plays in stabilizing and enhancing the memory. Dunlowski and colleagues found that when students held study sessions that were short and spread out over time, they had higher accuracy and better recall for the information as compared to information studied during single, longer study sessions. At OSU, we're on a quarter system with an 11-week term. One effective approach to distributed practice would be to revisit prior course content or material weekly. Let's use a chemistry course as an example. You have your chemistry midterm, week 5 of the term, and your cumulative final, week 11. You wouldn't want to wait until week 5 or week 11 to revisit the material from week 1. Instead, consider building weekly review of prior material and topics into your study sessions. As a general rule, try spending 80% of your chemistry study time during week 2 on new material from that week, and 20% of your time doing review problems or practicing test questions from week 1 material. The following week, you'll spend 80% of your time on new material and 20% reviewing information from weeks 1 and 2. The big takeaway we hope you get from this section is to spread out your studying over time. When you cram, you don't leave enough time to learn the material and transfer it to long-term memory. Giving yourself more time to process and repeat the information will help you better prepare and be confident with your tests.